Okay, so now I have connected my PLC programming cable. It is a normal USB 2.0 programming cable, and it is connected to my laptop USB port as well. So if I zoom in over here, if I show you the cable, this is the cable, right? So I have simply plugged it like that, and it's good to go.
If I go to the software part, you can simply download the software from this link, select the PLC, and from the software category, select this PLC editor. Because I'm using LX3V, so I can simply use this one. I don't have to use this one.
Hi everyone, in this lesson we are going to program our Wecon PLC using its software. So let me just check if it's recording. Yes, let me open Wecon PLC editor. So this is the software, which is completely free. It is hardly 118 MB, I believe. It's available for free on Wecon website. I will share the link as well. So it has a layout, a mixture of Delta WPL software or FATEC WinPro ladder, right? We can read, write PLC from over here, monitor the PLC, or online edit the logic from over here. We have simulator available as well. I can click on simulator and test my logic, verify with PLC, diagnostics, and there are ladder functions. And then on the left side, we will have some instructions as well that we are going to see. The project manager instructions. This would be visible once I select the PLC. If I go to new, my PLC is LX CPU, PLC series, PLC type is LX3V, and I am choosing ladder logic. For now, this is the only function available. I'm not sure if they have the advanced version. I feel they had one more version on their website, which might have multiple languages available, but I have not tested that. So everything is available. As you can see, all the instructions, timers, counters, move, everything available on the left side. We have program manager, which is really cool, so that I can see my program structure, comments, different parameters, and device memory. There are different functions available for subroutines, interrupts, statement, and then I can simply drag and drop the instructions as well. Other than that, I have information input, search, PLC verify, cross reference to search some bit, right? And there are some clock settings over here. Okay, so the most important step would be, after selecting your PLC model, go to transfer setup. I'm using my USB cable, as you can see in the video. I'll do connection test, and it says successfully connect. I'll say okay, and then I can create my simple program. I'll make a logic of X001, and then choose a coil Y001. So input and outputs are labeled as X and Y, which are absolute addresses, right? If I name it in human form, for example, input 1, output 1, that would be symbolic addresses. So these are absolute addresses. These are similar to what we see in Mitsubishi PLCs, right? Further, I can take their short keys as well, or I can select from over here. And guess I'll select from over here. And then I'll compile my program. The gray area would be removed automatically. I have to save the program 1. And then if I go to write to PLC, this window would pop up. I'll select everything, write comments, parameters, main, although I haven't put any comments, but it's all right. I'll click on execute. Yes. And my program has successfully downloaded in my PLC. It says PLC is ready to drop. I'll click yes, and it would run. You would see the run indication on PLC as well. So now let me put this on monitor mode, right, and go to my PLC. So as you can see, if I connect my common pin over here, so my input is on and my two outputs are on as well. You can see on the indications on the PLC as well, and on the software as well. So we have successfully created our first program, and tested it on our Wecon PLC. Thank you.